other day. Probably because it was darker.
We've got photographs, Mike, and three photographs, and they look different. Amazing, isn't it? Yeah, just in different sunlight.
Mike, what's your number, Mike?
01530.
Right, back to the ghouls. That was a small toy to shop.
And as you said, you can't see enough of them through binoculars. You've got to catch all of them.
Yeah, I know what you mean, yeah.
Well, I mean...
This common North American thrush is their equivalent of our blackbird, and its habits are very similar. American robins have been fairly regular over the last 10 years or so, whereas in the 10 years prior to that, they were very rare indeed.
Two white chairs, just get down,
that's it.
There's no more bellies now, so if you want to be off. There he goes.
This bird was last seen around Primrose Bank on the 13th of February. This first winter Pacific diver was the first of several records claimed in January and February. This bird in North Yorkshire displayed all of the expected field characters of this new split from blackthroat to diver. Points to note are the dark chin strap, the dark ventral strap, the dark ear coverts, and the fact that the white flank patch, which usually shows prominently on black-throated, is absent on this species. Note also that the dusky ear coverts mean that there is very little white behind the eye, unlike black-throated diver. It should be interesting to see how records of this new species develop in Britain. Phalaropes in summer plumage are always a big attraction, especially the brighter coloured females. This stunning female Wilson's phalarope was therefore a huge crowd puller on the weekend of the 5th and 6th of May. The bird spent much of its time trailing behind various dabbling ducks, picking up any food that they disturbed. News of a white-tailed plover at Caerlaverock soon had many twitchers driving to southwest Scotland. This was the first twitchable one since the first record way back in 1975. At Caerlaverock, views were rather variable, sometimes showing well near the tower hide, but at other times being very distant. After 3 days, the bird disappeared overnight on Friday, leaving many travellers disappointed on Saturday morning. Fortunately, it was refound at Leighton Moss Reserve on the Sunday, but again was rather elusive and distant for most of its 8-day stay. These closer sequences were taken from Campbell hide, which unfortunately lacked the height to see over the long grass and sedge. It must be remembered that these hides were built to watch wild geese, which stand much higher than a white-tailed plover. The nearest breeding birds to Britain are in Turkey, where it is still rare, with wintering sites being in northeast Africa and India. News of a brown flycatcher in the Old Fall plantation at Flamborough caused quite a stir. The news broke too late for most birders to get there before dark on the 3rd of October. Fortunately, the bird was still present the following morning, resulting in probably the biggest twitch of the year. This is the first acceptable record of this Asian species in Britain, with previous records from Fair Island, Holy Island having been rejected. Initially, it was a difficult bird to video, mainly because the sun was actually behind the bird, looking from the best viewing position. By mid-afternoon, the sun had moved round enough to give these better shots of the bird.
You'll be looking through all the leaves, right to the big tree.
This bird was only present on the 3rd and 4th of October, consequently disappointing many other would-be observers on the 5th of October. With only two previous British records, this mourning dove on North Uist was guaranteed to attract attention. It was found on the 1st of November, only a few miles from the site of the last record in 1999. This one remained much longer than any of the previous birds, surviving near Karnak until the 7th of November. It was no doubt helped by the grain that was put down for it to eat. The mourning dove is the most common and widespread dove in North America, and as the northern populations are migratory, it is not surprising that it should turn up in Britain from time to time. Indeed, another mourning dove was found in Ireland just one day after the Karnak bird was discovered. This sequence shows the last sightings of the bird, taken at about 4 p.m. on the 7th of November, prior to a wet and very windy night. A Pechora pipit, reported to be showing well on the 20th of November, seemed too good to be true. It certainly was giving brilliant views. This species is usually considered to be very difficult to observe, as it creeps through vegetation like a mouse, and is very difficult to flush. However, this bird at Goodwick Moor gave superb close-up views as it searched for food in the shallow pools right next to the footpath. This is an extremely rare bird on the British mainland. For instance, I have only seen one other in more than 30 years of twitching. Perhaps its rarity is more to do with its usually secretive habits, making detection almost impossible in long vegetation. The Pechora pipit, named after an area of Russia to the west of the Ural Mountains, is a scarce bird over most of its range. Its range stretches almost the entire breadth of Russia, mainly in a narrow belt, sandwiched between red-throated pipit to the north and olive-backed pipit to the south. To me, the most striking feature of this pipit is the almost black and white stripe defect when seen from the rear, created by the wing bars and the stripes down the back. This individual was last seen on the 23rd of November. But it was much more elusive on that day.
On the board. On the board.
On the board.
On the board.
On the
back, all right.
I've got it, do you remember? It's against the hatch, it's back to us there, so it's got it standing out as well.
Oh, yes. I still have to stand on the tiptoes here. No, it's all right.
His wings.
The one over the track.
Yeah.
Thank you. you could just make the thing grey line out if it's ever done that.
Anybody not seen it?
It's directly leaning over boy. It's not here. It could be a crab.
Thank you.
back on the island now.
Go lower, can't we?
Oh, you probably need it. Could you really just go again? Thank you. Keep your head down.
It's moving.
Right, all of you who are here, please, can you listen to what other birders are saying? Don't lean on the van, it's somebody else's property.
Sometimes it stays, sometimes it flies the area. But once you've seen it, that's the important thing. But I'd be grateful if, you know, once you've had views and you've got photographs, if you want photographs, and you could leave the area quietly. I'd be very grateful for that. And if I've not got a May I take a
If you look past that bush, first three branch,
Brilliant.
Okay. have. Okay. Right. No.
Let's go now. Sea Boat 66.